This video is for nerds like me who write their own game engine from scratch. The Quick Vox casting algorithm works both for 2D and 3D and requires you to have AABB collisions implemented. It has logarithmic complexity. Now I'll quickly show you how it works and then explain it in detail. Given two points, start and end, and dimensions of the box we are casting, for example, size of the player. To check whether there are no obstacles towards the end point, we need two. First, check whether the points are too close, depending on your desired precision and distance units. Personally, I use 1 pixel for maximum accuracy. If so, then we consider the space between points having an obstacle and return the endpoint. Second, create the rectangular area out of the two points. Third, check whether there is a solid object overlapping the area. Fourth, if no, the box casting is done. The path is clear. Fifth, if something overlaps the area, then we find its center point and create the two sub-areas. The first one encloses the starting point and the center of the area, and the second one contains the center and the finish point. Sixth, then for both sub-areas, we repeat steps from 1 to 5. If any of them turns out to have an obstacle, then the whole area has an obstacle. The finish point of this sub-area is the ray contact point. If the point equals the given finish point, then the ray hasn't collided with anything. Now let's go in detail. But firstly, I would like to say that I didn't research the topic much. I just needed to optimize the recasting for the game I'm working on. Previously, I used the most stupid approach, just launching the collision box towards finish point with some fixed distance step. Needless to say, the approach was unoptimized, inaccurate, and didn't scale well with the distance between points. So I iterated over several algorithm variations and came up with the one we are discussing in this video. The main point here is to reduce collision checks count and to provide a way to cast non-zero sized objects. So let's discuss how to take into account dimensions of the object. Actually, it's pretty easy. We already know the origin point of the object and its padding. Remember, we are talking about axis aligned bounding boxes here. When creating the area containing two points, we just need to expand it using the padding of the object, always. Why is this so important? Consider this case where the ray seems to go without any disruptions, but actually it has dimensions and will collide with the red obstacle. In case you need a code snippet, here is how I have implemented the algorithm in C#. I'm almost sure someone has invented it before me and probably gave it a name, but I could not Google it, so I'll be using my own name.
Recursively divide by two rectangles and check objects within. Returning end.
It takes two points we are casting from and two dimensions of the object in the form of its 2D paddings, list of objects to check collisions with, kinda the collection of your entities or some optimized iterator, doesn't matter actually. Magic freaking boolean showing whether the enclosed ray goes freely from start to end. Here I check for the point's proximity. Why do we consider this case to have collisions? I freaking have no idea. However, when the ray encounters a collision, the algorithm goes recursively shrinking the area and bringing the points together. These lines simply stop though. Then we create the rectangular area. Remember to add paddings. Here I'm checking for the collisions. If none, we did a good job and the casting in this area doesn't have collisions. The last step is to call the method recursively for the two sub-areas. If either of them returns collision, then the ray cannot pass the whole area. Else, there is nothing to stop this brave guy from walking his fate. At the beginning of the video I said the algorithm can be used for 3D collisions as well. I actually haven't tested it, but that's what you need to do. Step 0. Have implemented 3D AABB collision check. Step 1. Add Z-axis paddings parameters. Step 2. Use 3D vectors instead of 2D ones for finding distances and calculating centers. That's actually everything I wanted to share with you. If you have any suggestions on the algorithm improvements, don't be afraid to share your ideas in the comments under the video. Thank you in advance.